Greetings and salutations. Grace unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. This is Wesley Webb, pastor of Grace Baptist Church in Greater Downtown Metropolitan Mackby, South Carolina, and welcome to another Higher Grounds podcast and today's Morning Minute Meditation. I'm interested today in a word that's often used to describe the throes of depression, and that's the word darkness. In my own personal experience, I've used phrases like a dark cloud hanging over me, a dark hole I can't get out of, a dark time in my life, overwhelming feeling of darkness, darkness in my heart, darkness in my mind. I was repeatedly describing depression with the word darkness and didn't even realize it. I got curious one day and did a web search to see how many others were describing the word depression with the word darkness. And what I discovered was that people from all walks of life, from all over the world, from all different generations, commonly use the word or some form of the word darkness to describe their depression. That caused me to get curious about what applications can be made from the scriptures regarding the darkness of depression. One such portion I want to mention to you today is the first mention of darkness in the scripture. It's Genesis chapter 1, verse number 2. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. When you as a Christian are in the darkness of depression, remember that the Spirit of God was moving over the same deep waters that darkness was upon in the beginning. The first mention principle teaches that if the Spirit of God was moving on the same deep waters that darkness was upon in the beginning, then the Spirit of God is still at work today, moving on the same heart and the same mind that the darkness of depression is upon. I know this isn't a cure for depression, but what it is hope and encouragement to a believer that God hasn't forgotten about you in your dark episodes and bouts with depression. All I'm trying to say is, God knows where you are and what you're going through. His Spirit is a lot closer than you think it is, just moving, hovering over your life. So hang in there. Further, I encourage you to do your own study of darkness in the Bible and see what the Spirit of God will reveal to you about the darkness of depression. There are literally dozens and dozens of mention in the Bible of the words dark, darkness, and other forms of the word dark. Well, that's all for today's Morning Minute Meditation. Y'all have a great day, and remember, it is what it is.